in this quick DaVinci Resolve tutorial, I will share with you guys how you can create this awesome looking text animation by using the masking and few other tools inside of DaVinci Resolve 18.5. It is very simple and easy to create, but will give you an impressive and unique result. This text animation or motion graphics is very useful for cinematic video editing project. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so before we get started, make sure to hit the like button for this video to appreciate my hard work. And if you are watching this video for the very first time, please subscribe and do a comment below this video if you have any question. So this is DaVinci Resolve 18.5 edit page, and before we get started, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is the full HD resolution. But if you want to create this animation in 4K, you only have to select the Ultra HD option from here. And now let's select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for smooth animation, but you can select 24 frames per second for cinematic. And now you can click on save. After that, we need an image for this animation, which is the most important thing. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media and select an image. So in this case, I'm using this image that I have downloaded from pixels.com. So I will give you a link in the description for that, so you can download this image and then you can click on open. So here we have the image. As you can see, it's looking like this. You can use this type of any image that you like. Now let's drag and drop the image on this timeline just like that, and the duration of the clip is 5 seconds, which is good enough. After that, we have to fit the image first. So select the image, just go to inspector window, and here we have the zoom. Let's increase the zoom value, so set the value 1.2. Perfect. Here we have to convert this image into a fusion clip, which is very important. So just right click on this image, and here we have the new fusion clip option. Just click on that. Now this is the fusion clip. After that, let's go to the fusion page. And here we need only one viewer, so you can click on the single viewer. And as you can see, here we have the media in and out node. So we have to make this image a little bit better. So what we have to do, let's add a color corrector node first. So this is the color corrector button. Let's drag and drop the color corrector node on the flow window. Hold shift on the keyboard and attach this color corrector with this media in and out, just like that. It's very simple. You can right click on this flow window, go to arrange tool and click on to grid. This will help you to snap these nodes on the grid. Before we proceed further, let me tell you, this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on the topic, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Skillshare offers creative classes designed for real life and all the circumstances that comes with it. These lessons can help you to stay inspired, express yourself, and introduce you to a community of millions. You can check out this course on Skillshare Creative Video Storytelling and Editing by using stock videos by Nikki Stephens. With stock footage, everyone can create compelling video stories, no camera necessary. In this 1 hour class, designer and video editor Nikki Stephens will show you how you can create perfect video storytelling by using only stock footage. And we have a good news. The first 1000 people to use the link given in the description will receive a 1 month free trial of a Skillshare Premium. Just go to the link in the description and check this out. After that, we have to do some color correction with this image because it's not looking good. So what we have to do, let's do some color correction in the inspector window. So this is the inspector window. If you don't have the inspector window, you can click on the inspector and just go to the saturation. Let's increase the saturation, which is the color value. So I'm going to set the saturation value 1.5. Here we have the channel. So select the channel RGB, red, green, blue, and this is the lift. So let's down the lift value. I'm going to set the value -0.1. That's looking like this. These settings depends on your image. So you have to do the color correction by yourself according to your image. Anyway, let's focus on this image. So just go to the red channel, and here we have the contrast. So let's increase the contrast and set the value 1.8 maybe. All right, and then leave the green as it is. Just go to the blue channel, and here we have the gain. So let's increase the gain value and set the value 1.8 maybe. Now it's looking perfect. You can see before and after. So this is before and this is the after. Now it's looking much more better, as you can see. After that, just click on the single viewer. Now let's do the main thing, which is the text. So let's add a text tool on this flow window by dragging like this. Here we have to type anything that we want. Drag and drop the text to the viewer. After that, we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Century Gothic font style, which is my personal favorite font style. You can use any font style that you like. Now let's increase the size of the text. So I'm going to set the value 0.2. Perfect. After that, we have to merge this text with the main output. It's very simple. We only have to take a new merge node. So this is the merge button. Let's drag and drop the merge on this flow window. Hold shift on the keyboard and attach this merge with this, just like that. Make sure the yellow point is connected with the color corrector. And here we have the green point, which is the foreground point. Let's connect the green point with the text. And then you can drag and drop the media out, which is the final node, to the viewer. All right, after that, let's create the mask, which is very important. So what we have to do, just drag the color corrector node to the viewer. We need clear visibility of this mountain. After that, let's attach the B-spline tool. So what we have to do, hold control on the keyboard and scroll up to zoom in. So take your time and create the mask just like that. I'm gonna do this step in fast forward. Now we have to close the connection. So just click over here by holding shift over here as well, and then click on the first point, just like that. After that, we will get the round corner. So we have to make it sharp. So what we have to do, add a point over here and over here, and do the same thing over here as well. And now let's attach the B spline with the text, just like that. And then you can drag and drop the media out to the viewer. After that, we have to invert the B spline. So select the B spline, and here we have the invert option. Let's check this option invert. Now we have to do one more thing. Just select the B spline, hold control and scroll up to zoom in. And here we have to add some feather. So this is the soft edges. Let's increase the edge softness. So I'm going to set the value 0.003. Perfect. Click on fit button. After that, we have to animate the text. So just go to on frame number 120. But before that, let's remove the automatic keyframe from the B spline tool. So select the B spline, right click on the text, click on remove B spline 1. Now it's gone. After that, we have to animate the text. So select the text, go to the frame number 120, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 60 frames per second. And then just go to the layout. Here we have to place the text right over here. We can put the round figure value for better output. So I'm going to set the value 0.57. Perfect. And then right click on center, click on animate, and then go to the very first frame of this animation. Let's drag the text like this. And after that, we will get this type of text animation. But this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Check this option, text 1, click on fit button. Highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Hold this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Perfect. Here we have the second handle. Let's place the handle right over here. Basically, we have to create a smooth curve, and then you can see the smooth animation. All right, now you can close the spline window. After that, we have to add the zoom out animation. So let's arrange the node first. Just select the merge one, add a transform node just after this merge one. This transform is going to be the scale animation, so hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. Let's call it a scale. Hit enter. Just go to the end of this animation, right click on size in the inspector window, click on animate. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the size. So I'm going to set the value 1.2. And now we will get this type of zoom out animation. Now we have to add some atmospheric particles. So it's very simple. Just go to the media pool. Right click on that. Click on import media. I will use the pre-made atmospheric particles. So select the particle. Click on open. I will give you a link in the description for that. So don't worry, just drag and drop the particles on the flow window. So this is an optional step. If you want, then you can add. Otherwise, you can leave this step. Hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. Let's call it particles. Add a merge node. So this is the merge node. Let's drag and drop the merge on this flow window. Hold shift on the keyboard and attach this merge just like that. Make sure the yellow point is connected with the scale. And here we have the green point. Let's drag the green point and attach this with particles. After that, we have to hide the black section. So select the merge 2. Let's go to the inspector window. And here we have the apply mode, which is the blending mode. So let's change the blending mode to screen. And now it's almost done. So just go to the edit page. And here we have the awesome text animation. So hit Control F to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. And if you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.